Hey, nay, nay, yonny, hi-yo. Hey, nay, nay, yonny, hi-yo.
In 1990, Congress passed Public Law 10-3-43, which authorized a request to the President issuing a proclamation designating the month of November as National Native American Heritage Month. Congress chose the month of November to coincide with the conclusion of the harvest season for Native Americans. In celebration of Native American culture, the 49th Wing would like to highlight a couple Native American members from Holloman Air Force Base.
Yat A She'e Latoya Duncan Yunishye, Deshchini Nishlon, Tretchini Bashishin, Kiani Dashache, Twitichini Dashanele, Teta Twok Ol Ade Ayusinasha, Holloman Air Force Base Deshugan. So the English translation for that is, hi, my name is Latoya Duncan. I am born for, started the Red Streak people, and I am born from Red Running into Water people. My paternal grandmother is Towering House, and my maternal grandfather is Bitter Water. I am originally from Casimiro Lake, New Mexico. I am now stationed at Holloman Air Force Base with my children and my husband. So the reason why we traditionally introduce our clans when we're saying who we are is because it creates a connection to the person you're speaking with on what level of relation there is, because the Navajo tribe uses a clan system. Culturally, it is definitely family-oriented. Everything surrounds the family unit. I mean, things like taking care of your elders, that's to be expected because that's your family. Everyone always gathers at grandma's house and celebrates the holidays or birthdays. Oh, growing up on the reservation was, I would describe it as like a free feeling. We would ride our bikes everywhere. My brothers and I would go on hikes in the mesas. We'd climb rocks. We'd just explore, like, outdoors. So now that we're stationed in New Mexico, we have the opportunity to go home and see my family. And my daughter, she's normally, like, super girly dresses, like ballerina shoes, but once she gets onto the reservation, she's like, I need my tennis shoes and I want to go run around outside. They love it out there because it is the reservation and they get to play outside whenever they want and do whatever they want. They get to explore, which I really like. I like the fact that they get to do that out there opposed to here where it's like our tiny backyard, or I have to watch them constantly because of the streets out there. You go outside and it's just open. It's open land. It's open. It's free range. They could walk around the house. They could walk to their neighbor's house, and you really have no worry about them, honestly. And then when I left for BMT, they stayed there on the reservation. And when I graduated, they came down to come see me in Texas, and I also really enjoyed that. I'll always remember that when I first got to see them again. Throughout the whole time of BMT, I was doing it for them.
I am the first in my immediate family to serve in the U.S. military. When I decided to enlist, my parents were so surprised and dumbfounded on why I wanted to join the military or where the idea came from. I mean, I appreciate that there was opportunity to travel and move around and experience different cultures firsthand.
Being Native American and being in the military is also one of the biggest accomplishments I see. I'm very thankful for how far I've come, very happy that I get to incorporate my culture into the military, and knowing that there are people out there who find us interesting and who want to know more. And if you do, it's fine, you can just ask and we'll give you information that you would like to know. We're people too.